My name is Dr. Kirstie Whitaker. I started out as a physicist, thinking that I would cure cancer. But all you have to do is just look at children and see how they run around and how they learn things and how they change so quickly over their childhood to just wonder, well, what on earth is going on with them? Adolescence is a period where people are very likely to have their first episode of depression or anxiety or psychosis. Why then? And is there a way that we could tell that someone was at risk of developing those disorders? I discovered the Allen Brain Atlas by working with a colleague of mine, Dr. Petra Vertes. She had been downloading these huge files, and it's an absolutely heroic amount of work that the people at the Allen Institute have undertaken. We linked up parts of the brain that were changing an awful lot. They were actually increasing in myelin. And we showed that there are certain genes that are related to that change that are expressed in association cortical regions. Instead of just doing what most MRI studies do, which is see a change related to age, we were actually able to link up the biological processes that we think are underpinning those changes. The fact that the Allen does all of this work, they scale it up and then make their data available to people like us, is just something that's never been done before, and it's a wonderful step forward for scientific discovery. I don't think it's possible that we'll ever answer why people develop mental health disorders, but I really like the idea of trying to find out if there are major interventions that make a significant difference. We're not going to get rid of mental health disorders, we're not going to get rid of the feelings that people have, but we might be able to support them better and minimize their suffering.